Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about enzyme classification. And before going to classification, so little bit about naming or nomenclature of enzymes. Usually, enzymes end with the suffix "-ase". That means they begin with the name of the substrate which act on and end with the suffix "-ase", like lactase, sucrase. So like this, most of the enzyme, they end with suffix "-ase". But it is not true, because there are few enzymes like pepsin, trypsin. So these enzymes is not with a suffix "-ase". So, International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, so this stands for, they come up with unique name and code number, systematic name and enzyme code number. So it is, usually we call it as Enzyme Commission number or enzyme code number, both are same. So these are the unique name and the number given by International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. So I will be talking about this enzyme code number after giving the classification. First we will see classification of enzymes. So enzymes are classified by the reaction they catalyze. That means the International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, they classified enzymes according to the type of reaction they catalyze. So there are totally 6 classes of enzyme. The first class of enzymes are called oxidoreductases. So they have different subclasses, and I will be making a separate video for each of these classes by giving example and what are their subclasses. In this video, just I will be giving the classification. Oxidoreductases means those enzymes which catalyze oxidation and reduction reactions. The second class of enzymes are known as transferases. So as the name suggests, so these enzymes involved in transfer of some functional groups from one compound to another compound. Third class of enzymes are called hydrolases. So as the name suggests, these hydrolases enzymes, they break down compounds by adding water. So they make hydrolytic cleavage. So cleavage means breakdown of compounds. The most of our digestive enzymes are hydrolases. The fourth class of enzymes are called lyases. So lyases means again lyase. Lyase means breakdown. So breakdown of compounds with some specific groups other than by adding water. The bond like CC or carbon oxygen bond or even carbon nitrogen bonds. So here water is not utilized, but compounds are broken down, especially carbon carbon bond, carbon oxygen bond or carbon nitrogen bond. So these reactions are catalyzed by a group of enzymes. They are fourth class of enzyme. They are called as lyases. Fifth class of enzymes are called isomerases. Isomers means they have same molecular formula, but they are different respect to their structure. So that means these enzymes helps in rearrangement of atoms within the molecule. So rearrangement of atoms within the same molecule. One isomer will be converted to another isomer. So like glucose 6 phosphate will be converted to glucose 1 phosphate, or glucose 1 phosphate will be converted to fructose 1 phosphate. So these are all enzymes which are named as isomerases, and they belongs to class 5 of enzyme classification. So the last classification is ligases or ligases. So ligase means joining. So these enzymes makes the two compounds joining together. While this process of coupling or joining, there is also associated with hydrolysis of ATP. They require energy. That energy is supplied by hydrolysis of ATP. So joining of compounds or two compounds coupled with hydrolysis of ATP, catalyzed by the last class or sixth class of enzyme, they are called ligases or ligases. So these are the 6 classes of enzymes. So and when we write 6 classes, we should not interchange. So class 1 is should be always oxidoreductase. The class 4 enzymes must be always lyases. and the class 6 enzyme must be always ligases. So when we write the enzyme classification, you should not start with ligases or isomerases. You must start with oxidoreductases. There is a mnemonic to remember this classification. So you can remember these 6 classes by remembering this mnemonics. OTHLIL. So this is in order. So this is class 1, this is class 2, this is class 3, this is class 4, 5 and 6. Oxidoreductase, transferases, hydrolases, lyases, isomerases and ligases. This is how you can remember the classes, the 6 classes of enzymes. The explanation for each class and example I will make separate video. Now we will see, so this enzyme commission number or enzyme code number given by International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. So according to them, each enzyme has got unique number and each enzyme number starts or begins with EC. So EC means enzyme code or enzyme class or enzyme commission number, and followed by they have 4 digits. For example, 1, 1, 1, 1. So like that, there are different numbers for different classes of enzymes. We will see what this first digit stands for. So after EC, there are 4 digits. The first digit stands for class of enzyme. So in this particular case, you can see here. So number 1, EC1 means this is always the class 1 enzyme, that is oxidoreductase. So one of 6 classes. If the EC begins with the 5, that means it belongs to isomerases. Second digit stands for subclass of that particular enzymes. So this subclass are mainly classified depending upon the type of group involved in that particular reaction. That means the enzyme reacts on the group, specific groups. Depending upon this specific group, they are subclassified. So that is second digit. So type of group involved in this particular enzymatic reaction. That means enzyme must be act on this particular group. For different group, number will change. So here the second digit may change to 1, 2, 3, 4, depending upon the groups which these enzymes act on that particular enzymatic reaction. The third digit, it is called subclass. Here the third digit represents the acceptor group involved in that particular reaction. So second digit is group. What is the group which is involved in this particular reaction? And the third digit, so what is the acceptor molecule for that particular enzymatic reaction? So acceptor group, or in some cases it is molecule or compound. The last digit or fourth digit, so this fourth digit represents serial number of that particular enzyme in that particular list. So here the series enzyme EC111. So the last digit represents the first enzyme in this particular series, EC111. So like that, if it is 2, that means it is the second enzyme in this particular series. That is the usefulness of fourth digit. So I will explain with the example, you will understand better. So I am going to explain this enzyme code number or enzyme commission number by taking the first enzyme, that is EC1111. So the name of this enzyme is alcohol dehydrogenase. So by looking at this code, we can say this enzyme, or I can write here EC1, means it is belongs to class 1 enzyme. So 1 stands for class 1 enzyme. It is class 1 enzyme is oxidoreductase. Okay. Now the second digit here represents subclass. So that means EC11. So this 1 represents subclass. Here the functional group these enzymes can act is CHOH group. So these enzymes, that is the class 1 enzyme under their subclass, they can act on this CHOH group, then they will belong to EC1 and subclass 1. Now we will see the third digit, EC1, 1 and 1. And this, the third digit here represents acceptor molecule. So here if it is 1, the acceptor molecules are either NAD plus or NADP plus. So the third digit usually represent the acceptor molecule. So in this particular enzyme EC111, the acceptor molecule is either NAD plus or NADP plus. Now we have EC in that class 1 oxidoreductase. It acts on CHOH group and the acceptor molecule is NAD or NADP plus. And the last digit, fourth digit, is the serial number. So here it is the first enzyme in this series. So first enzyme in this particular series, EC111. And the name of this enzyme is alcohol dehydrogenase. Suppose we have here EC1, 1 and 2, then here you can see if it is the third digit is 1, then the acceptor molecule is either NAD plus or NADP plus. If the third digit is 2, then the name of the enzyme will change because the acceptor group is different now. The acceptor group is cytochrome. So in same oxidoreductase, there are different subclasses of enzyme. If the acceptor group is NAD or NADP, we can call it as dehydrogenase. I will talk when I will deal with the individual class of enzyme. Again, I will give another example. So enzyme class 1, subclass 1 and subclass is, if it is 3, then the acceptor molecule is oxygen. So like this, International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, they assign different numbers for different enzymes. So I will explain with another example. So here in this case, EC2711, so the name of the enzyme is hexokinase. So hexokinase usually catalyze conversion of glucose to glucose 6-phosphate. And in this particular reaction, so there will be transfer of group. You can see here phosphate. Here in this glucose, there is no phosphate. Here we have phosphate. So that particular reaction requires hydrolysis of ATP to ADP. And here the EC2 means it belongs to class 2. So that is transferase. And EC27 means the transferring group or the group involved in this particular reaction is phosphorus containing group. So the functional group is phosphorus. You can see here glucose converted to glucose 6-phosphate. So the phosphorus group from ATP, one of the phosphate group from the ATP donated to glucose, so that glucose will become glucose 6-phosphate. And the acceptor molecule here it is, that is the third digit EC2, 7 and 1. So the third digit represent the acceptor molecule in this class 2 enzyme series. So the acceptor molecule is here alcohol group. So we know that glucose contains H and OH group, and in the 6 carbon it has got CH2OH group. So the OH group is alcohol. This OH group accept this phosphate group, functional group. So alcohol group is act as acceptor molecule. Alcohol group of what? Alcohol group of glucose. Now we have the serial number, that is 2, 7, 1 and 1. That means in this series EC271, so this hexokinase is the first enzyme, hexokinase. Okay, in this series, suppose I will take another example, EC271 and 2. So here is the second enzyme. So the name of enzyme is glucokinase. Okay, I will take another example now. 2, 7, same series, but the third enzyme is ketohexokinase. So in this series, that is EC21 series, the third enzyme is ketohexokinase. Similarly, EC271 series, the fourth enzyme is fructokinase. Okay, enzyme code number is a 4-digit number, and the first digit represents class of the enzyme, and the second digit represent the subclass or the functional group involved in that particular enzyme catalyzed reaction. And the third group represent the acceptor molecule in which this enzymatic reaction is involved. And the fourth digit represents the serial number of that particular enzyme in that particular series. If you want, you can just Google this website where you can put any number in this block and it will tell the name of the enzyme. Or either you can put enzyme code number here or you can put name of the enzyme. So it will give details of the enzyme class. So if you type any number here out of 6, it must be started with 1 to 6 number, and here you can give any number, it will give detail of that particular enzyme, what is the group involved, what is the acceptor molecule, what is the serial number of that particular enzyme. So this is a very useful website, you can Google and you can explore yourself for different enzyme. If you don't know the EC number, you can type the name of the enzyme in the search box and it will give enzyme code number. So this is with respect to naming, nomenclature and classification of enzymes. If you like this video, please click thumbs up icon below this video. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe my YouTube channel for future notification. Thanks for watching.